Okay. So there are so many type of element which are addition of voltage drop across each element, either passive or active, is equal to zero. Or we can say that algebraic addition of voltage drop across the passive element is equal to the voltage drop across the active element. Okay. Or we can say that what is the voltage drop across the active element? It is called EMF. It is called electromotive force EMF. It is not potential difference. We cannot say potential difference of battery. We have to say potential difference, not potential difference. It is EMF, electromotive force of battery. Okay. The terminology, we have to use different terminology for different cases, different parameters. Okay. So algebraic addition of voltage drop across each element is equal to zero. Or algebraic addition of voltage drop across each element is equal to total EMF supply. We can say also like that.
It is, I think, a better way.
Algebraic addition of voltage drop across each element is equal to, it is the Kirchhoff law. Now, fourth concept, these three laws are sufficient to solve any type of electric network. But there are so many, some method by which we can also, we have also remember always to solve electric network. First is current division rule. First is voltage division rule. Voltage division rule. Okay. What is voltage division rule? If two resistance are connected in series, let us consider R1 and R2. Okay. And some voltage V applied across the combination of these two. So it is V1 and V2. Voltage drop across V1 is equal to across R1 is equal to V1, and voltage drop across R2 is equal to V2. So we can write V is equal to V1 plus V2. Or what is V1? Let us consider I current will flow. So what is I current? You know very well, I current is V equal to R equivalent. Okay. First write it down, then from first I will again explain voltage rule, voltage division rule. Okay, first write it down so everybody has written it.
Yes sir.
Okay, so I am going to write these 2 points, please remember always: active element and passive element. Now, voltage division rule. Voltage division rule. Okay, so let us consider two resistance R1 and R2 and a battery V. Connected across the parallel combination of these two. So due to this current I, since current is entering from these terminals, so it will be positive, and leaving from this, so it should be negative. Again, for this second, it will be positive and it will be negative. It is V1 and V2. And I is equal to, what is I is equal to V by R equivalent. So in this case, V by R1 plus R2. You know very well. Okay. Now, what is V1? V1 is equal to I into R1. So V1, we can put value of V, I, it is equal to V into R1 divided by R1 plus R. So this is V1. And second, same as it is, V2 is equal to I into R2. So V2 is equal to V into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. So this formula always you have to remember. This is the current voltage division rule. Okay. And it is very simple. V R1 divided by R1 plus R2. V R2 divided by R1 plus R2. We can find directly potential difference. No need to find current. We can find directly potential difference. Okay. Okay. Now division rule. Division rule. Yes, Vanshika, any doubt?
Sir, will you explain it again?
Yes. Yes, don't worry. So next is current division rule. What is voltage division rule? If we apply V voltage across V R1 and R2, which are in series, then we know very well that voltage is divided. V1 total voltage is divided into V1 and V2. Let us consider V1 across the R1 and V2 across the R2. So what is I? I is equal to V by R equivalent. You know very well. This concept already we have covered. So I is equal to V by R equivalent. And what is R equivalent in parallel in series combination of two resistors? It is R1 plus R2. So V divided by R1 plus R2. Now what is V1? V1 is equal to I into R1. What is voltage drop across these R1? It is V into I. So V is equal to I R. Into R1. So V1 is equal to, we can put value of I, which is V divided by R1 plus R2. So V1 is equal to V into I1 is equal to V divided by R1 plus R2, and R1 as it is. So V1 is equal to V into R1 divided by R1 plus R2. Simple. Same as it is, V2 is equal to I into R2. So V2 is equal to V into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Very simple. Okay. This is called voltage division rule. Voltage is divided. We understand by an example.
So current division rule. Let us consider this R1.
Let us consider 10 ohm resistance and 60 ohm resistance. And we are applying 3 volt battery. So find V1 and V2. To find V1 and V2, no need to find current at all. You can find directly V1. You can find directly V1 by voltage division rule. What is V1?
Divided by 10 plus 60.
That is equal to 30 by 70.
Sir, it's not clear.
3 by 7 volts.
Sir, your voice is not clear.
Yes, sir, it is not clear.
Okay, don't worry. It will be clear soon. Okay. Now, is it clear?
Hello?
Yes, it is clear now.
Okay. So, what is V1? To find V1, no need to find current first. Directly we can find V1 by this formula. V1 is equal to V R1 divided by R1 plus R2. So V1 is equal to what is R1, which is equal to 10 into 3 divided by 10 plus 60 R1 plus R2, which is equal to 3 by 7. Same as it is, we can find V2 directly. V2 is equal to R2. What is R2? This is R2 60 into V. This is V3 divided by R1 plus R2, 10 plus 60, which is equal to 6 into 3 by 7, which is equal to 18 by 7. 18 by 7 volt. So this is the V2. Very simple. Okay. So this is very useful concept to find voltage directly to solve electric network. If you want to find voltage directly, you can find very easily. Okay, because so many cases in fusion directly we require direct answer. No need to solve whole circuit. If somebody want to require potential drop across any single element, then directly you can use this formula. Okay, so it will make easy. It will make your time short. Okay, please write it down. Now current division rule. What is current division rule? This voltage division rule is very simple. The concept is very simple, but current division rule is little bit typical. Okay, so you have to understand. You have to concentrate on the board, then you can understand. Okay, everybody. Please concentrate on the board. What? Current division rule.
Current division rule. But if you understand this concept,
the solution of electrical network, any electrical network, will become very easy. Let us consider I current is dividing into two resistance which are in parallel. So I1 and I2. I current is dividing into two resistance which are in parallel. Okay, so what is value of I1? I1 is equal to I total current into opposite resistance divided by R1 plus R2. Same as it is, what is I2? I total current into opposite resistance. I2 is equal to total current I into opposite resistance. We have to multiply opposite resistance. Why? Because it is property of resistance. It is property of any resistor is that it opposes the flow of current. Okay, so the value, if value of R1 is larger, then I2 will be larger. If value of R2 is larger, then I1 will be larger, inversely proportional. Okay, how you can solve it? How we can solve? We know that I is equal to R1 plus R2. Please listen me carefully. I is equal to I1 plus I2. You know very well. And V1 is equal to V2. In parallel combination, current is divided and voltage is same. Current is divided and voltage is same in parallel combination. So this I1 can be written as this V1 can be written as R1 I1, and V2 can be written as R2 I2. And after solving these two equations, this is equation number 1 and this is equation number 2, we can find I1 and I2 in terms of I. Here we have to find I1, I2 in terms of I. So first equation is,
first I2 is equal to I1 R1 divided by R2.
First I am finding value of I2. Now this I2 I will put into equation number 1. So I is equal to I1 plus I2. This I2. Because I just want to find first I1, then after automatically I2 will come. It is kind of first, I think, first concept of your class in mathematics. Solution of equation of two variables. Okay, linear equation in two variables, x and y, same as it is I1 and I2. So it is replacement method. Okay, so
just put value of I2.
So I1 plus what is I2? It is I1 R1 divided by R2.
Now we can take common I1.
So 1 plus R1 by R2 into I1. So I is equal to, now LCM, R2 and R2 plus R1 into I1. Now this R2 will multiply to the I, and R1 plus R2, this R2 plus R1 can be written as R1 plus R2 into I1. Now, what is I1? I1 is equal to I into R2 divided by I1 plus I2. Okay. So this is simple I1. You have to multiply opposite resistance by total current, opposite resistance divided by total resistance. R1 and R2. This is R1 and R2. My mistake. I hope. I1 is equal to I into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Same as it is, if we put value of I1 in this equation, just put value of I1 in this. Okay. Value of I1 in I2.
So I2 is equal to I1 into R1 divided by R1 divided by R2 into I1. What is value of I1?
This is I1. So I2 is equal to R1 by R2 into I into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. So R2 will be cancelled out and I2 will be I into R1 divided by R1 plus R2. This is I2. Very simple. So this is the current division rule. These two formula you have to use to find individual current. If you know total current, if we have idea about total current, we can find individual current in resistance. So I1 is equal to I into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. And what is I2? I2 is equal to I into R1 divided by R1 plus R2. It is inversely proportional. To find I2, we have to multiply by opposite resistance R1. Same as it is.
To find I1,
it is I1. To find
I1, we have to multiply
opposite resistance R2. But in case of potential, in case of potential division rule, V1 is equal to V into R1 divided by R1, because potential is directly proportional to R and current is inversely proportional to R. That's why, simple. Please write it down. Okay. So these are some concepts which can use to solve electric networks. Let's take an example. So I think whole concept is clear for you. Example is there like that. This is 2 ohm resistance, 5 ohm resistance, no, the 6 ohm resistance and 3 ohm resistance and 4 volt battery is applied. Okay, just listen me carefully. Now you have to find current I in 6 ohm resistance only. Okay. Find current I in 6 ohm resistance. Now what we can do, okay. First, we can find equivalent resistance and the total current IT. Okay. Okay, let us consider this I and it is I1. Now we have to find I1. So first we can find equivalent resistance. So equivalent
combination of these two, equivalent combination of these two is 6 into 3 divided by 6 plus 2, which is 6 plus, which is equal to 2 ohm.
Little blur.
Okay.
No, sir, it is clear.
Okay.
Sir, it is clear.
No need to say clear or blur. I know very well that so many students are not getting proper net. So it may be possible video or board blur for some time interval. So no need to say. Just wait for a minute. Automatically it will clear soon. Okay? So no need to worry.
Okay, otherwise video is available.
Okay. Now the parallel combination of 6 and 3. So 6 into 3 divided by 6 plus 3, which is equal to 2. Now series combination of 2 and 2. What is series combination of 2 and 2? This 2 parallel combination can be replaced by 2. So series combination, the total equivalent resistance R equivalent, we are getting 4 ohm. Okay. So this combination can be replaced by a single resistance 4 ohm and 4 volt battery is connected. Then current I is equal to 4 volt battery divided by 4 ohm resistance, which is equal to 1 ampere. Very simple. I equal to 1 ampere. So the net amount of current is flowing is 1 ampere. Okay. Now just take only this part of circuit. Okay. Just take only this part. What? Here 1 ampere current is coming and dividing into two parts of 6 ohm and 3 ohm. This is I1, this is I2. Then what is I1? I1 is equal to total current I. 1 ampere current will exit from the battery, leaving from the battery, and come to the 2 ohm resistance, then go for the 6 and 7, and some current it will divide in form of some I1 and I2. So this is I1 and I2. 1 ampere current is entering in form of I1, I2. Okay. So what is I1? I1 is equal to I into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. So what is I? I is equal to 1 ampere. What is R2? Which is 3 divided by 6 plus 3. So I1 is equal to 3 divided by 9, which is equal to 1 by 3, means 0.33 ampere. So this is answer. Directly we can find answer. Okay. Same as it is, somebody wants to find I2. So you can find I2 directly. How? If 1 ampere current is entering and dividing into I1 and I2, so I2 will be I minus I1, simply. Or you can use formula what? I into R1 divided by I1 plus R2. So it is 1 ampere. What is I2? 1 ampere minus 1 by 3. So it will be 2 by 3, which is 0.67 ampere. I2 is equal to 0.67 ampere. So this is the answer. We can find directly current. We can find current in each element. Okay. Just write it down. It out, you can ask.
Sir, done.
Okay. Now, some homework is there. Question number one, this is homework. This is 5 ohm resistance, 10 ohm resistance, 15 ohm resistance. Okay, and 100 volt battery. Find current in each element. Question number 2. This is 2 ohm resistance, 4 ohm resistance, 3 ohm resistance, and 5 ohm resistance. So, no, it is 3 plus 7. Just wait. This way. 8 ohm resistance and 20 volt battery. Again, find current in each element. Current across each element. Okay. Now, doubt. I was given a question like that. R, 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 and R. These 2 points A and B. Okay. This was yesterday homework. So first solve these two. Okay, because same current is flowing, so these two are in series. Okay, these two are in series. So R and R are in series, 2R. So this is 2R. Now, R as it is, these are as it is. And we can replace this series combination of 2 by single resistance 2R. Now, these two are in parallel because current is dividing here, here, and here. But here is R is connected, so the combination these and these are not in parallel, only these two are parallel. So first we have to find parallel combination of these two, then we will find series combination of this R. So it will be 2R into R divided by 3R. So it is 2R by 3. Okay. Now what we have to do? This R are in as it is. Now these are as it is, and the parallel combination is 2R by 3. It may be possible you are thinking that R in series, but it is wrong because these are connected here. If you are thinking that these are in series, but same current is not flowing. Okay, so these are not in series. So you have to solve by this form. But in these two, same current is flowing. So these are in series. So 2R by 3 plus R. It is equal to 5R by 3. Okay. Please note it down. These homework assignment. Okay. Now we can replace these two resistance by 5. This R, R and R as it is. Now these two are replaced by by 5R by 3. 5R by 3. Now these two are in parallel. So R into 5R by 3 divided by R plus 5R by 3. This is equal to 5R by 3 divided by 8 by 3. So 3 will be cancelled out. 5R by 8. Okay. Now these are and this R 5R by 8 and R. These three are in series. Okay. We can replace these two by 5R by 8. So total R across AB is equal to R plus 5R by 8 plus R. So it will be 2R plus 5R by 8. So 16 plus 5, I think 21 R by 8. So this is the correct one. So note it down. So many problems, so many students. It is not 3, 20. It is 8, 21 R by 8, Muskan. You have done some mistake. Let me check. Yes, you have done mistake, Muskan. Yes, Harsh Patel, you can send today. I had forgotten to send you homework, so I can send it today. Yes, you can send, Mr. Head. You can send. Okay. So I think it is 10 for today. Let's solve an example also. So can I rub board?
Sir, 2 minutes.
Okay, Abhay Raj is saying 2 minutes. Okay.
Now you can.
Yes, no need to rub the board. So again, everybody have give attendance. Have to give attendance. Just write down present right now. It's your full and final attendance. Only 51 students are there. So it's final attendance. Yes, present, Eta present,
Okay, Neet, Palin, Arya. Okay, very well. Okay. Yesterday I got assignment of so many students and I have write down name of all these students and also these students are saved in all of you are saved in my WhatsApp group. So just okay. श्रेया अभय योर सबमिटेड असाइनमेंट महक श्वेता सूर्या सिद्धि निहारिका जय वंशिका मिस्त्री ओके आयुष्मान सो मेनी स्टूडेंट कृष्णा कृष सन अभय नम्रता धैर्य हरिता ओके आई गॉट असाइनमेंट ऑफ यू प्लीज अगेन यू हैव टू सेंड असाइनमेंट टुडे So it is enough for today. Okay.